Here it is. This is the new chip, a brand new piece of electronic technology produced by Cybus Industries. You're probably wondering how it works. Well, all you have to do is get this tiny little chip and place it onto the back of your neck. And, as they say, the product will do the
That's the last time I travel by short hops. According to my calculations, the TARDIS should be here. Wait, what? How could I have crossed universes?
Sir, Sergeant Nathan Bothwell, reporting for duty.
At ease, soldier.
Sorry for barging in, sir, but we've picked up life signs in the wasteland.
Show me.
This can't be possible. I know I've been to a different universe before, but that was by accident. This can't be right. The TARDIS couldn't have materialized here. Unless she got stuck on the other side.
That can't be right.
Why, sir?
Because this is supposed to pick up what species this is, and according to this, they're unknown.
And that means?
They don't exist.
How can they not exist?
I don't know, but I'd like to find out. Sergeant, prepare a squad. Let's bring them back to base.
Well, she never took me where I wanted to go. But she did always took me where I needed to go. What?
Come on, get in!
What?
Quickly! So, what were you doing out there?
You won't understand.
Try us.
Trust me, you wouldn't understand.
Okay.
You're lucky, you know.
Why?
Well, usually they would have killed us by now.
I see. What happened here? I gather it has something to do with Cybermen Industries?
Hold on, why should we tell you anything?
Because I might be able to help.
Everyone here might be able to help. What makes you any different, hmm? Besides, you won't even tell us what you were doing out there.
I can't tell you why I was out there. Because when people begin to even understand who I am, they get in danger.
How can we become more in danger than we already are?
Fine. I'm the doctor. I come from another time and another universe. I came here because my ship was trapped at the border of the multiverse, and signs indicate that it is still around here. Now tell me, what happened? What caused this destruction?
What is the meaning of this disturbance? Cybermen, Unit 78954 has detected inferior life forms on the surface. How many life forms were detected? 4 humanoids and 1 unknown. Scan the hive mind. Find the unknown. Cybermat unit has been able to locate the location of the humanoids. Excellent. Prepare cyber units for maximum deletion.
So sorry that happened. You don't seem surprised with what I've said.
Yeah, well, nothing really surprises me anymore these days. Not after the cracks in the sky with the Cybermen.
Can you hear that? Everyone, into the base, now!
All personnel to the main control deck. I repeat, all personnel to the main control deck.
Right, listen up. I know what you're all thinking right now, and I'm thinking the same thing. And I'm terrified. But you have to remember, if you're gonna go out fighting! Everyone, to battle positions.
General, you can't do this.
Why not?
You're asking why? This is a suicide mission.
Yeah, sir. The doctor does have a point here. These people will die if they go out there.
You don't think I know that? Every time we have done this, don't you think I have realized that I am risking their lives?
Yes, sir.
But why are you risking their lives? What's the point? You know your weapons do not work, yet you are willing to risk the lives of innocent people.
I don't know what the point is, Doctor, but listen here and listen carefully. This is my base. This is my team. What I do here doesn't concern you.
How doesn't this concern me? I told you back there that I could help and fix what has happened to your world, and yet you've shown your true colors.
See you on the battlefield, Doctor.
Thank you.
For what?
Trusting me.
Yeah. When you mentioned that, I put everything into perspective, really.
Why? What has he done?
He risked countless of lives for nothing. Yet I didn't think about it at the time, but really, nothing has changed. You'd think, with the many years we've been doing this, we would have upgraded our weapons by now.
I'm sorry, but you never told me how long this war has been going on for.
6 years.
6 years too long. I think it's time to end it.
On my signal! Fire! Fall back! Fall back!
I'm sorry. I know you can't hear me, so listen to this. This war will end today, because this place is protected. I am the Doctor, and I'm the man who stops monsters.
Cyber Squad 7, locate the 2 survivors. Delete the impures. Only two humanoids remain in this area. Excellent. One of the remaining impures is the unknown. Excellent. Bring them to me alive.
What are we going to do now? Haven't you notified them that we've survived?
No, because as you can hear, they've already found us. Why fight them now?
What do you mean?
Well, you didn't really go out onto the battlefield, did you?
Yeah, but you didn't go onto the battlefield either, yet I can still see in your eyes that you are still intent on stopping this. And, if I'm rightly speaking, I'd rather go out fighting.
Hello, I'm the Doctor. And who do I have the pleasure of meeting?
Your presence has been requested by the Cyber Leader.
Looks like my day just seems to get better and better.
How is that better?
Because we're not dead. So, this is your little base of operations.
You will not speak when in my presence. Weapons will not be necessary.
So, then why did you bring us here? Why didn't you just kill us like what you did with all the others?
You are different to the others. You are an unknown species.
I see. The Cybermen who are keen to know about biology. That's something you don't see every day.
Who are you?
I'm your worst nightmare.
If I may ask a question. What happened to the people here?
Yeah, that's a good question. What happened to the people here?
They were upgraded.
And the people with the chips?
Those chips were only phase one. Those people were weak, so we made them better, made them stronger.
Stronger? You call ripping away people's emotions making them stronger?
Yes. Emotions make you weak.
You say emotions make us weak. I'm sorry, but emotions are what make the best of humanity.
Incorrect. You are impure to us. You require an upgrade.
And turn into one of you? No! Over the last 6 years, I've seen my friends slaughtered, murdered, tortured, just for them to reappear as one of you metal freaks!
Nathan, I don't think that was the best of ideas.
The upgrading process will begin. You will become like us. Take the impures to the cyber conversion chambers.
Whoa. Wait a minute. You can't convert me.
That is incorrect. You are a humanoid and will be converted.
Well, partially. I may look like a human, but I'm far from it.
Error. You do not have human biology. What are you?
I thought you would have guessed that. Well, since on your lifetime reading, I do come up as unknown.
What are you?
Time Lord.
Since you cannot be upgraded, you will be deleted.
Oh, and you're telling me I'm making it worse.
At least it has given me a chance to figure out how we are getting out of here.
Prepare for maximum deletion.
If I may ask, you know, before you delete us, what is your plan, huh? After this, what are you planning to do to the rest of the planet?
This planet will become the next greatest cyber fleet.
That must be a big career growth for you, because that is not going to happen while I'm around.
All cyber units. Kill the Emperors. Our weapon system error. What is happening?
Sorry, that would be me.
Why are we not dead?
Well, using the screwdriver, I've been able to reverse the feedback in the Cybermen's weapons, causing them to malfunction and shut down. But if I do this, like I said, that's not going to happen. Not here. Not ever.
Is that it? Are they gone?
No, not yet.
Not yet?
Yes, not yet. If I'm correct, with a cyber army of this size, they should, in theory, have a hive mind.
A hive what?
A hive mind. It's what the Cybermen use to communicate and share information. So if my calculations are correct, if I send some sort of shotgun count to the hive mind, it should shoot down all the remaining Cybermen.
So, is that it then?
Theoretically speaking, yes.
What's going on now then? I don't really have anything to go back to.
Yeah, about that. Once I get back to my ship, I'll take you to somewhere new. Come on, you can do it, old girl.
That's your ship. It's just a box.
I'll have you know that this box has dragged this planet halfway across space. I see you've redecorated. It looks nice. Yeah, I'm sorry.
So?
Ah, yes. Just catching up.
Oh, I get it. You're catching up with your box. Yeah, everyone does that.
I'll have you know that this box is one of the most powerful ships in the cosmos.
I'll believe it when I see it. Okay. Take it back. Take back what I said. It's,
big on the inside. Yeah, I get that a lot.
How does it do that, then?
Trust me, you wouldn't understand.
But it can't do that. It's impossible.
Nothing's impossible if you put your mind to it. Now then, shall we be off?
Off where?
To the colony.
Couldn't you have picked something more modern?
I have you know this is modern. Well, on the planet Delphron.
Why do I have to stay here? You could have shown me the wonders of the universe inside that box of yours. Why can't I come with you?
In my last life, whoever got close to me died.
Last life?
I'll explain another time. Now go. I already sent out a message. They should be expecting your arrival. Goodbye, Nathan. I hope our paths can cross again.
Goodbye, Doctor.